Hello and a warm welcome to all the viewers of Markets and Money Control. I'm Mariam Faruqi and this is a segment where we tell you everything that matters to your portfolio. Bulls on Wednesday failed to continue the momentum as Nifty came under pressure. The index started the day at 10,042 level but made a high of 10,067, but it closed at intraday low of 9,984. What can we expect on D Street today? We will find out, but first a look at the headlines. Morgan Stanley's Rithim Desai expects Sensex and Nifty earnings to triple in the next 5 years. On the IPO front, General Insurance made its debut yesterday and the mega IPO subscribed 80% on day one. And there's one more good news, petroleum dealers have called off their Friday strike. These were some of the updates. Now let's get chatting with Money Control editor Santosh Nair and find out how the markets will fare today. Hi Santosh, good morning.
Good morning, Mariam.
So you know, in the last two trading sessions, we have been seeing heavy selling and the buying was missing. So what can we expect in markets today?
Well, Mariam, there seems to be some bit of nervousness as the second quarter earnings season has got underway. The numbers that have come in so far, they do not inspire much confidence. And even otherwise, expectations are not high. Demonetization and GST are expected to pressurize margins as well as profits to a large extent. So no major surprises there, really. Already the first couple of banking results that have come have been below expectations. So you have generally a fairly bleak picture, a bleak outlook on the macro. Now, the CPI number for September, the consumer inflation reading for September will be reported today, and that's being keenly watched, and most analysts are expecting a slight rise, and that could be more bad news, in fact. On the global front, markets have been pretty steady. Right now, Asian markets are trading mixed. US equities ended slightly higher today. Crude still is at elevated levels, although it has stabilized a bit, and OPEC says that there could be a production deficit in 2018. So the near-term outlook on crude as far as India goes is slightly bearish. Prices are expected to climb a bit and that could put further pressure on government finances. So at this point, when you have the earnings season underway and not many major surprises there, the attention is on both the earnings as well as the macro picture, both of which do not inspire much confidence. So I think market could see some bit of consolidation around these levels.
Right, Santosh. So about technical charts, so yesterday Nifty first, it was a U-turn because it made highs and then lows. So how are markets looking on technical charts today?
So it's a bearish pattern. On the positive side, the Nifty is still above its short-term averages, but the next level that technical analysts are looking keenly to is 9950. They feel that in case the index fails to hold above this level, you could see further selling pressure which could drag the index below 9900. On the upside, 10,080 is the near-term resistance level for the index. Only above this level should traders seriously think of going long. Now, foreign fund selling has abated a bit over the past few sessions. Yesterday, they sold close to about 200-odd crore going by the provisional figures. But on the other hand, buying by mutual funds also appears to have eased a bit. Now, that could be also because there's a flood of IPOs and a lot of money is getting diverted that side. So pretty much it's an even tussle for now between foreign funds and the local players.
So let's talk about money. So what are the stocks to watch out for?
Mariam, all eyes will be on the TCS quarterly number. That's the biggest of the tech numbers. The company is expected to report a 4% increase in net profit for the September quarter and about a 2.6% rise in revenues. Now, generally, IT stocks have not done all that well over the last couple of months. They have been mostly under pressure. But because of the slight weakness in rupee, sentiment has changed for the better. Marginal though, most players still are looking at it as more of a trading bet than anything else. IndusInd Bank will be announcing its report, its second quarter numbers today. Net interest income is expected to rise by about 25%. Now, IndusInd Bank, the previous quarters, mostly the numbers have been above expectations. So the stock closed slightly weak yesterday. Bajaj Corp is the other company which will be announcing its quarterly numbers today. And if you look at stocks in which there was good delivery-based activity on Wednesday, these include Britannia Industry, Wipro, Z Entertainment and Nestle. A lot of short build-up there in the futures of banking stocks, Union Bank, Canara Bank, Allahabad Bank and Bank of India also huge buildup of short position. The outlook on the banking sector in the short term is fairly positive, more so for PSU banks.
Thank you, Santosh. That's all for now. But for more cues, views and analysis, log on to moneycontrol.com.